All right, this is the show, a demonstration of why you cannot trust a power supply tester, one of these basic cheapies. They're a good first step, but you definitely cannot trust these things. If they read bad, you can trust that they're bad, but if they read good, that's not necessarily a promise that you have a good power supply. If you look here, and the focus is terrible on this little handy cam, but that capacitor right there is bad. It's domed up. See if I can get a better picture here for you. It's obviously domed up. And what we're gonna do here, I had this power supply plugged in, and here's what we get. Numbers are pretty good. We got, you know, the negative 12 is 11.7, which isn't great, but you know, everything else, 4.9, 12, 3.3, 11.7, 11.9, 4.9, power goods 250, which doesn't matter. And you know, this is obviously straight to that power supply with the bad capacitor. They're a good first step. They are a good first step. If they read bad, you can assume that the power supply is bad. But if they read good and you're getting issues, don't assume that the power supply is good. That's the number one thing to keep in mind. If you do crack a case on a power supply, you have to be extremely careful. Don't touch any circuits. These two things right here will knock your socks off and then some. You just have to treat them with kid gloves and don't touch anything inside. But it's a good way to tell if your power supply is bad. Look for any bad capacitors. You know, even if you're getting good power on this, this does not test under load. This just tests basic flow, you know, with no load on it, other than the very little bit it generates to test the power itself. So don't trust them. You'll end up with something like this and you'll never figure out what the problem is.